day when Pentecost arrived, the disciples were together in one place. And suddenly a sound came from heaven, like the rush of a mighty wind. And it filled the house where they were sitting. And there appeared to them tongues of fire, distributing and resting on each of them. And they were filled with the Holy Spirit.
once again you open the gateway to another morning, and your glory comes through it.
We thank you for your church, the visible fellowship of all our true sons and spirit, who across the generations have had a great tradition of goodness and truth. Our prayer this morning is that you might find your servant with your children in love. Give me our way this day. Give us a new grasp on the things unseen and eternal. Save us from the temptation of believing only what we see. Save us from the cynicism of this generation. Keep us from the skepticism of the doubt. Lift us from all false expectation. And may your command in us a true devotion to the life of living Christ. Expand our love this day.
Be reminded again of this promise.
I will pour out my spirit upon all people.
May the peace of Christ be with you.
Also with you.
Let us greet one another with the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Inside aisle HQ. Please print clearly and include your address or email so that we can make our welcome more personal during the meeting. Please extend a warm welcome to dancers Jesse Seth Campbell and Ethan Jameson this morning in honor of Pentecost. We are welcoming dancers into our service with multicolored banners representing the rush of the mighty men, the tongues of fire distributed and resting on the disciples and the Holy Spirit. Sunday luncheons will begin next week on Memorial Day, and the sign-up list is out there and posted. The Dayboro Walton team has already taken a spot, so spots are going fast. Please take your bulletin home so you can read them anyway, so you can serve others in our community.
Sunday school room. to do its intended purpose, that we need the Holy Spirit to fill us so that we can be all that God wants us to be. Landon, will you sit next to Pastor Jack in the balloon? Hold that. Thank you. And let's have a quiet prayer, if that's possible, with a blue flag. All right, will you repeat after me? Okay. Dear Lord, we thank you for sending your Holy Spirit. We thank you for breathing life into the church. We thank you for giving your Spirit to all who believe. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
God is always near us. Open our eyes this morning. Let the eyes see more clearly. And our ears, that we might hear you more intimately. And our hearts, that we might be more in tune with you and more responsive to your touch. We humble ourselves in prayer. Your power is truly overwhelming. Your wisdom infinite. So it is, we praise you. For all the kindnesses that bring down on us, we gratefully thank you. You've been a light on our pathway. And your passion for us is all consuming. Your eyes watched over us and been a protecting force in our lives. Forgive us for the many times and ways that we have presumed on your love and grace. When we live in a world and fail to realize it and everything in it belongs to you. Oh God, you know the burdens we bear for the evil we see around us. And we pray especially for the families of those who were murdered this week, not only in Santa Fe, Texas, but in places and situations that happen to us. Forgive us for the part we play in the hatreds and divisions in the world. Forgive our prejudices and set our desires on higher attitudes and better things. Not that I've already attained this or am already perfect. But I press on to make it my own. Because Christ Jesus has made me his own. Friends, I do not consider that I have made it on my own. But one thing I do. Forgetting what lies behind, straining forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Let those of us who are mature be thus minded. And if in anything you are otherwise minded, God will reveal that also. Only hold truth. Friends, join in imitating me. And mark those who so live as you have been sampled in us. For many, of whom I often told you, announced by Peter with tears, live as enemies of the cross of Christ. Their end is destruction. Their God is their stomach. And they glory in their shame with minds set on earthly things. But our commonwealth is in heaven. And from it we await the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will change our lowly body to be like his glorious body by the power which enables him even to subject all things to himself. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to you, God. Pray with me, will you? Lord God, we ask that you would shower down at this moment your Holy Spirit on these words, that they would not be my words or my thoughts alone, but that they would be your holy and living word for us today. We know that will be. For we pray with great joy and anticipation in the strong name of Jesus, the risen and the reigning Christ. Amen. They were absolutely filled with this horrible, horrible fear, this consternation, this confusion. The greatest army that the world had ever seen to this point in time was standing tiptoe on this precipice, not at all certain what was about to fall before them. They were worried. They were afraid. Their future was uncertain. They were not at all sure what was out there. We're talking, of course, about the great army under the leadership of Alexander the Great. They had stormed through Asia Minor, and no one had been able to stand up against them. They had defeated every foe in their march through that part of the world. No army was able to challenge them if they came out. But suddenly, as they emerged from the forest, there before them stood this enormous, unnamed mountain range. They scurried to their maps to see what this was before them, and it had gone unpictured, unnoticed. They had looked at the GPSs of their day, and there wasn't anything to explain what stood before them. Everything out there was unknown. And they suddenly realized that they had marched off the map. Ahead of them stood the Himalayas. Wasn't there on their map? And beyond them was the end of the world, I suppose. Harold Lamb, in his brilliant biography of Alexander the Great, said that the great general, sensing this unrest and this confusion and this bewilderment and this fear, gathered the army together and he proclaimed to them, "Most armies like to stay within the neat confines of what they know. Most armies stay within the boundaries of their own understanding. Most armies stay within the limits of their maps, but the great army will always march off the map." I dare say to us this morning, every one of us, every single one of us, you and me included, have at some point come to the third of their, to the third of their premarital counselings. And as they walked into the office, the tension was such that you could cut it with a knife. Not wanting to avoid the elephant sitting in the room, I asked him, I said, "What's going on here? You seem very tense." And they said, "Jack, you need to understand, we have been discussing that all over the issue of the seating arrangements of the, at the rehearsal dinner with who was going to be sitting with whom." We talked about that for a few moments, and it's relative to the unimportant, and unimportance in the big scheme of things. And I remember so clearly that at one point, the groom sitting in his chair, leaning forward with his elbows on his knees and his hands tied up together, and he said, "Jack, just think, in 3 weeks we'll be married, and all our problems will be over." What about marching off the path? Marching off the map. Someone who is no longer